How long does a recurrent herpes outbreak last? After the first outbreak, the others are often shorter and less painful. They may start with burning, itching, or tingling where you had the first outbreak. Then, a few hours later, you'll see the sores. They usually go away in 3 to 7 days. There's no way to tell how many outbreaks you'll have. It's different for each person, but you probably will have the most in the first year. Symptoms for herpes can come and go. When you do have them, it's called an outbreak. It may start with tingling, then blisters on or around your genitals, anus, thighs, or buttocks. When the blisters break, they leave sores that take a few weeks to heal. They usually won't leave any scars. Your first outbreak is usually the most intense and might seem like the flu. You may have a fever, aches, chills, and feel very tired. You might also feel stinging or burning when you pee. This outbreak usually lasts 2 to 4 weeks. Can I prevent outbreaks? Doctors don't know what triggers outbreaks, so there's no sure way to prevent them. Here are some things you can do that might help. Eat healthy foods. Exercise often. Get the sleep you need. Find ways to lower your stress. Onset of first outbreak. The first outbreak of oral herpes usually develops within about 1 to 3 weeks after infection. This initial outbreak may last for up to 3 weeks. With genital herpes, the first outbreak usually occurs within about 2 to 20 days. Similar to oral herpes, the initial outbreak may last as long as 3 weeks. Herpes outbreak symptoms. Generally, the first outbreak of herpes is more severe than recurrences that follow. Though sores are the most noticeable sign of infection, there are a number of other symptoms of herpes that typically occur only during the first outbreak, including flu-like symptoms such as fever, muscle aches, swollen lymph nodes in the neck. Herpes sores progress through a series of defined stages as they develop. The following is an approximate timeline for the first outbreak of oral or genital herpes after infection. Warning signs. About 12 to 24 hours before an outbreak, itching, burning, or tingling sensations are felt where the cold sores are about to appear. Blister formation. On day 1 of the outbreak, blisters appear as fluid-filled red bumps that are painful to the touch. Sore formation. The blisters rupture and the fluid inside, which is usually clear or yellowish in color, oozes out. The resulting sores continue to weep for a day or so. Scab formation. On about day 4 or 5 of the outbreak, the sores start to crust over. The scabs that form may crack or bleed as the sores heal. Skin healing. The scabs eventually fall off around day 6 or 7. It's best to let this happen naturally rather than picking at the skin. The skin underneath will still be a bit pink or reddish. Over the next 1 to 2 weeks, the area where the cold sore appeared will heal completely and return to its normal tone. Differences between oral and genital herpes outbreaks. The location of the sores is the main difference between the two types of herpes. Oral herpes sores generally develop on the mouth and lips, usually at the border of the lip where it meets the skin of the face. Genital herpes sores can occur in a wider variety of locations depending on where the virus entered the body. These locations may include: for women and men, urethra, buttocks, anus, thighs. For women only, cervix, vaginal area, external genitals. For men only, scrotum, penis. During an outbreak, a shot of intravenous medication or oral pills may be recommended to help shorten the duration of symptoms. For those with frequent outbreaks, doctors may prescribe a daily antiviral medication, also known as suppressive therapy. These medications can make outbreaks less severe and less frequent while also reducing the risk of transmission to others. Some of the prescription antiviral medicines used to treat both oral and genital herpes are valacyclovir, Valtrex, famciclovir, Famvir, acyclovir, Zoavax and Zatavig. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe to my channel.